Welcome to Yes Bitch TV, honey, yes God. Thank you guys so much for clicking on the video. Please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. Also, by hitting that bell, you can be updated each and every time I'm uploading something new. Thank you guys so much for joining me for another Hot Topics video. But before I begin, I wanted to say a few things. First and foremost, to the new subscribers, thank you guys so much. Slowly but surely, Yes Bitch TV's numbers are rising. I definitely want to try to get to 500 subscribers. I want more, obviously. Who doesn't want more, okay? Let's push that envelope. So continue to like, share, and comment, and engage in the channel. I'm going to be doing my utmost best to bring you guys more content. Again, to the new subscribers, I know most of you are over here due to Really Be TV. Thank you, girl. Thank you for sending and shouting out every reviews as well. Just everyone who's coming to my channel from other people's channels, even if I don't know about it, I just want to shout out and say thank you. You guys are definitely the reason why we do stuff like this. You know what I'm saying? It's not all about the numbers, but the more people that watch your stuff, the more your message gets out there. The more of your talent gets out there. The more of whatever it is that you're trying to bring to the people get out there. So again, we are nothing without you guys. So yeah, and me and Really Be TV, we're going to be doing our best to do more collaborations with one another as soon as these web series get their shit together. Okay, honey? Like, come on now, bitch. Beep, beep, who got the keys to the Jeep, okay? So we're definitely going to be doing our best to do more collaborative pieces together. Thanks to the new StreamYard service. Again, I don't even know if it's new, but everyone's using it now. And, you know, we're able to do more panel discussions, and it's very, very easy. So once things start kicking around and our schedules start freeing up, you'll definitely more than likely see some collaborations with us. I also wanted to make the announcement as well. Now that I'm kind of getting familiar with StreamYard, I am looking to conduct a panel of my own. Two panels, actually. I know it seems a little saturated, but you know what? I think that's the wave now. I think a lot more people are going to have more exposure due to these panel pieces. I am personally a fan of them. I actually started YouTube because of a two-panel channel that I was watching where they just talked about, you know, LGBT issues that affect the black gay communities, okay? And I definitely want to bring that back. So I'm going to be looking for 2 to 3 people that wouldn't mind. Personally, I would prefer black gay males. From any of the spectrum, I don't give a fuck. If you are interested, or anybody that's watching me that may know someone, share this video with them and let them know that I, Yes Bitch TV, I am looking for 2 to 3 black gay males from any side of the spectrum, it doesn't matter, to help me conduct a panel discussing issues that the LGBT community, more specifically the black LGBTQ community, faces, especially in today's time. I want to call it the Yes Bitch TV Hour, where we will take a couple of topics and break them down and talk about them and give our points of view and think about, you know, different solutions to the problems that we are facing within our communities. The other panel I also wanted to conduct, I wanted to call it the roundtable discussion. I know there's something already out there in the mainstream world called that, but since I call the people that come over to me like my roundtable, I wanted to talk about political things and things that are affecting our world, our communities as a whole, our social environments, just all of that shit incorporated into one show. So if anybody else is interested that wants to hop on that, that's a free-for-all. The Yes Bitch TV Hour, that's the gays only, honey, okay? But the other one, the roundtable discussion that I want to have on political perspectives and, you know, just talking about things that's going on in the world that affect our communities as a whole. So definitely stay tuned for that. So again, tag your YouTubers, and you know, even if you as a subscriber want to get involved, you can as well. I don't give a fuck. You don't have to be a YouTuber, as long as you have a great perspective and you know how to deliver that bitch. That's all I'm looking for. Okay, so y'all please stay tuned to those. And again, thank you guys so much for all your support. It means everything. Slow and steady wins the race. I don't really give two fucks about numbers, but I care about these messages that I'm trying to convey to the people, because I only talk about things that I know, and I only talk about things that are near and dear to my heart. And I would hope that a lot of these issues that are plaguing our world, our society, we can start having dialogues and we can start having real in-depth conversations. That way we can push the fucking needle where the fuck it needs to be pointed to. Again, we need to realize one big thing. YouTube is fun. It's meant for that. It's a great escape. But it also can be used to get your message across, honey. Okay? It really can. So stay tuned for better shit. Okay? Now, jumping into the hot topics really quickly. In YouTube news, I just wanted to announce Tai Couture has finally been laid to rest. His funeral was conducted yesterday, which was Saturday. And they went on live through his channel, and it seemed beautiful. I'm not going to sit through a live funeral. I just don't do that. I don't even sit in funerals in real life because I just don't like them. But, you know, may he rest in peace. You know, I know a lot of other people were sending their condolences and their love and their respects, and, you know, Tai CoutureTV will forever be missed. He is was a wonderful person. But again, you never know what demons people are struggling with on the inside. So again, be mindful how you treat people that you come across in this life. One day it might be you going through some shit. Okay. Always remember that. John Witherspoon was also laid to rest. I caught, you know, clips here and there of, you know, the homegoing service child. Let me tell you something. They were having a celebration of life. And that's what a funeral should really be about. Celebrating someone's life. I understand it is a sad moment and it is going to be hard to fight back the tears, bitch. But, you know, John Witherspoon lived a full life. He was a funny man. And it was really good to see like people like Sean Wayans and Ice Cube and Bill Bellamy. And, you know, just a bunch of people came up on stage and just kept it real, told real funny stories about his life and the things that he's accomplished and all of that good stuff. And just how other inside scoop shit, you know, that made it even funnier, but also made the magic real to know that this man had humble beginnings. He had a dream. He had a natural gift. And it just carried on, honey. So, again, may John Witherspoon rest in peace. Granddad will forever be missed, okay? I needed to talk about this, and it's a serious subject, and I would be a fool to not take the time out to have this discussion with y'all. This year alone, there has been many of reports of child abductions, and not just in the sense of sex trafficking, but in the sense of these kids are being raped and murdered, okay? And I want people to understand that there is a difference when it comes to those two different types of abductions. Now, see, if someone is abducting your child for purposes of sexual exploitation, sex trafficking, all of the above in that manner, there may be a way to hurry up and find them motherfuckers. But when you have these evil demonic fuckers that are stealing people's children just to fuck them and then kill them, there is something seriously wrong with what the fuck is going on in our society. Okay? Bitch, all of it's fucked up. All of it is the sources of all kind of demonic fucked up bullshit. But when you look at the grand scale this year alone, these motherfuckers are snatching your kids in the daytime, bitch. These motherfuckers are in the grocery stores, in the airports, in the malls, in broad fucking daylight around lots of people, not giving a flying fuck about how they're about to steal your motherfucking children from you. It ain't even about, oh, if the parent's there or not. They're stealing the children while the parent is present. And I think the idea, which I understand, is of course you ain't thinking like that in moments where you're right there next to your goddamn child, or you're at a child's birthday party, as we saw with the cupcake, the 3-year-old Miss Cupcake Honey. Like, seriously? You can't even be at a child's birthday party in broad daylight without worrying about a bitch running up to the party to snatch the children? PSA, watch your kids. Talk to your children. But how do you talk to a 3-year-old? 3-year-olds don't comprehend a goddamn thing. What are we going to do in our society to not only expose this dark world that is trying to snatch up our motherfucking children, bitch? I think I just read something that said yearly, close to 400,000 children go missing. And only out of that 400,000, 1,500 are actually child abductions. My mind went to thinking like, well, where are the rest of the motherfucking kids at? That's a small number compared to the larger number of the kids actually missing. So I think it's time that the federal government get involved, and y'all need to put together some kind of task force. We need to be running through these goddamn neighborhoods to make sure people are safe, because the things that we are seeing now, even grown women are being snatched up, bitch. They talking about beware of vans that are parked next to you in the parking lot, notes on your fucking windshield, don't even grab them motherfuckers. Like, it's getting to the point where people are that fucking bold. And also, I want to include this in here. Young lady out of Georgia from Clark Atlanta University was fucking just found killed. Her roommate and the roommate's boyfriend killed the girl. The poor dear reported her roommate's boyfriend tried to touch her and, you know, do all kinds of God knows what to her. She reported it. All of a sudden, fish go missing, and then she's discovered dead. So right now, the boyfriend and the roommate have been charged and awaiting trial and all that shit. So it's just like, you can't even be protected at school. Where can you go? If you can't go to Bella Noche's, where can you go? Shit. Let's be honest here. You have to protect your motherfucking kids nowadays, child. I'm telling you, protect them always and forever. But even more now, it's just a scary thought. One young lady, her daughter, she woke up, her daughter was gone. The door was open. You don't know who's walking in. You are some brave motherfuckers just walking in people's houses, snatching their children. Like, lately, these reports are through the fucking roof. We need to be very observant. We need to start installing cameras. We need to start putting tracking devices on our children's clothing. Like, it's going to get to that point where we're just going to have to really, like, be on that shit, bitch. Because your child, like, this can be gone from you. And when they say the first 48 hours are critical as fuck, they really are. Because, bitch, it takes nothing to get to Mexico. They just, my sister, we were talking, and she lives in Atlanta, and she was telling me of a story. She heard a young lady was kidnapped and about to be sexually exploited. She was about 15 years old. There was another 15-year-old girl that they were looking for, too. They did a raid on that bitch, and that motherfucking, the other girl was found in the closet in the hotel room dead from an apparent drug overdose. So this is the process. This is what I used to tell my niece child when she was being a little bad motherfucker. What is going to happen to you is, while you wanna, your kid's running around in the streets, or you got one of them fast-ass children that don't want to listen to your motherfucking ass, okay, bitch, what will happen to you, and this is real shit, you can look this up, this is what they do, you'll be walking down the street in defiance of your parents, and someone's going to pull upon you. And it's not going to be Aladdin on his magic carpet. It's going to be a boo-boo in a white motherfucking van that's been tricked out with soundproof padding. Yes, God. And some old, desperate, burnt-faced bitch that's like 80 years old with the strength of a gorilla. What she's going to do is she's going to lure you into the van with candy and God knows what else, because it's been days since you've eaten, because you want to be a stubborn cunt. So what's going to happen to you is they're going to inject you to knock you out. They're going to drag you in the van, girl. They're going to hog-tie your motherfucking ass and then continue to drug you. Okay, then you will be transported to a black site or some rundown hotel where no one asks questions. They can see a body being dragged into that motherfucker, and the hotel staff, motel staff ain't gonna say shit. Okay, they're going to continue to drug you. They're going to transform you into a woman, honey. They're going to allow $10 guys to come through and run through your motherfucking ass. Then what is going to take place is they're going to continue to transport you through these sex hubs that they've developed throughout these cities. If it's an emergency type of issue, if you are a somebody or a child that will be on Amber Alerts and shit like that, best believe they won't even waste no time shipping your ass to Mexico or Argentina, and we will never hear from your ass again. That's a message for the fast-ass girls who want to be walking around in defiance of their parents. Now, for the ones that's being good parents and the kids following directions because they get snatched up too, it don't matter about behavior. It don't matter about no kind of raising. Bitch, they stealing rich kids. They stealing poor kids. They stealing all these motherfucking kids. It don't matter. But now I'm seeing the uptake in black children being taken. And we know around the world there is a fetish for black skin. Let's just be honest here. It's very true nowadays. Black skin is one of the most sought after things right now. Let's just be honest here. There is a sick group of people out there in the world that have to be hiring these people. So this is a much larger issue than just some nasty crackheads in a van. Okay, people, this is a sophisticated system that someone has developed. Okay, that's what we need to be thinking about here. So again, the federal government needs to get involved. You need to be putting together task force to run through this motherfucking town. Each town that's being plagued with these girls can't even go to the bus stop no more, child. Not even the girl, they snatching the boys too. So you got to be careful. They're raising the boys to be soldiers and pimps. That's what they're doing. And they're raising the girls to be, you know, sexual providers and all that shit like that. Like, seriously? What is it going to take for the federal government? Y'all worry about all this other shit. Our kids are missing. People are on drugs real fucking bad these days. The global warming is going to fucking wipe us all out, bitch. So we ain't going to have none of this shit to worry about because we all going to be burnt to a motherfucking crisp or flooded out with water, bitch. So it's just like there's so many things going on in our world right now. And I don't think we should have to be worried about our motherfucking kids on top of that stuff. It's a shame and it's saddening and it's disgusting as fuck. And let me get a message out to you evil fuckers. You will be found. Whether it's by the police or whether it's by a private group of people, you will be found. More than likely beaten, tased. We will find you. You will be found. In hell, I don't even know what hell is like, but if it's, bitch, it'd be hot as fucking Florida, girl. So imagine 10 times, 20 million times the heat, bitch. You will be frost, you will be fucking filleted, mignoned, bitch. Stop this. Stop this. We ain't gonna have no motherfucking future because y'all too busy stealing our goddamn children, bitch. 400,000 kids a year go missing. That's a lot. That's a lot of motherfucking children. 5 years, you got millions of kids gone. Think about that. If you want to care about numbers so much, care about those numbers. And again, you got some bitch sitting around here right now talking about, well, it ain't happening to me. You never fucking know. I bet you them same parents said the same thing. It can never happen to us. You never know. Child, that's all I have to talk about today. I wanted to talk about more things, but I didn't want this video to drag on too long. And obviously, this particular subject matter is very important, and continue to watch, fight, and pray. And you need to start taking action, start having conversations with your children, be more friendly with your neighbors and the people around you, security cameras, whatever you can do to keep track of your children, your home, your area. Be watchful when you're going to the grocery store. And I hate telling people this because you should not have to be like that, but the day and age that we're at, bitch, you have no choice but to look around your motherfucking ass. Even when you at the ATM, bitch. When you pumping gas, the children running up on your ass, robbing you for your car and shit with your baby in the backseat, bitch. Like, honey, like, you're at Walmart, girl, and they're shooting motherfuckers in Walmart. You have to be very, very observant these days. It's sad, it's unfortunate, but if you want to save your life and protect the people that are around you that you love and care about, sometimes you're going to have to do what you have to do. I advise ladies, I advise young men, teach your kids how to fight. They have free PAL programs, police athletic leagues, in most cities. They offer boxing, martial arts classes. Like, send they ass there to the after school program. I don't give a fuck. They have free shit out there to teach these kids self-defense, okay? Like, honestly, and for the grown folks, get you a license to carry, get you a weapon, honey. I don't give a fuck, bitch. I got a motherfucking pistol. I got a 9mm, bitch. Okay, Miss Sister Mary Clarence, honey. I got a big-ass machete. I have a sword. Bitch, I got a fat-ass hunting knife. Bitch, I stay ready. I got a big-ass, I got three fat-ass sticks that'll wail a motherfucker out, bitch. What you talking about? You gotta be prepared. You gotta be prepared. Plus, I'm a 6'1" big motherfucker. So try it, bitch. If I don't break your motherfucking ass down, one of my many weapons should handle the motherfucking job. And it's getting that close time for the seasons, girl. Tis the season to be watchful, bitch. Okay? You out there doing your Black Friday and shit. You don't realize these young motherfuckers run up on your broke ass. Okay? Your broke ass. And he's spending your last and your rent money to get these Black Friday sales, girl. And your ass done got robbed. Or kidnapped. Or worse. Murdered, bitch. Raped and murdered. So you better, hide your kids, hide your wife, hide yourself, bitch. Because they raping everybody out here. Y'all be blessed. Never stressed. Have a great day.